that is because so many patients look so different from one another. And so because there is such a heterogeneous population that don't look the same from one another, even if they have the same genetic mutation, it makes it very difficult for us to know what to look for in each patient. Mitochondrial disease can look like anything. Patients can come to us with constipation as their only manifestation, and they may end up with mitochondrial disease. Same with diabetes or hearing loss. So because patients can look like anything, it makes it very difficult for us as physicians to know if it's a mitochondrial disease or something else.
I think it's difficult to diagnose because it affects multiple tissues, and as a consequence, someone may present to a psychiatrist, a gastroenterologist, a neurologist, and it's sometimes difficult because you're looking at little parts of the elephant, but not the whole elephant. And I think that's part of the issue. The other issue, I think, is based on genetics. Some diseases like Duchenne are straightforward. They're X-linked recessive disorders, whereas in mitochondrial disease, every type of genetics holds true. Maternal inheritance, autosomal dominant, autosomal recessive, X-linked recessive, and in the case of CPO, even sporadic inheritance is there. So it's a very complex genetic disorder. They're a complicated little beast.